price action trading can be difficult because you have a lot of things to check. You know, if you look at a chart, there are thousand and one things that you can consider. Okay, so in today's video, I want to show you five things that you need to check before placing any trades. Okay, these five things will help you approach the market in a systematic way. Okay, so think of this video as a checklist. Okay, it'll be good if you can write down these five things, and every time you take a single trade, you actually go through each of these things and ask yourself if you have really considered each of these five things. And if you have, then you can go ahead to place the trade. Okay, so this is the team from Financial Market Wizards. We create a lot of videos like this to help you become a better trader. Okay, so if this is the first time that you know you are visiting our channel, okay, welcome to our channel. We have a lot of videos like this. Okay, so in today's video, I want to give you something that you can use in your everyday trading, right? Something that you can help structure your thinking and make sure that you are following a proven process. Okay, because a lot of times new traders, they come into the market and they approach trading in a very haphazard manner. Okay, they do not have a step-by-step process which they go through every single time. So hopefully this checklist will help you do just that. Okay, so what will you be learning today? You'll be learning the five things. So without further ado, let's go into the first thing that you need to check. Okay, now the first thing that you need to check is you need to ask yourself, what is the market condition? Okay, and there are really only three types of market conditions. Okay, is it in an uptrend, downtrend, or consolidation? It's that simple. Okay, it's a very simple question, but I see a lot of traders, they make this mistake because it's so basic, they always miss this step. Okay, so please do not miss this step. This is very important. Okay, ask yourself whether the market is an uptrend, downtrend, or consolidation. Okay, so what is the uptrend? Okay, I have a brief introduction for you here. So just in case you are new to trading, you do not really understand how to trade. Okay, I just want to cover the basics, just touch a bit. Okay, so in an uptrend, what happens is that you have a series of higher highs and you have a series of higher lows. So you have a high here, okay, you have a higher high, and then you have a low, and then you have a higher low. Okay, that's how you define an uptrend. Okay, the downtrend is the opposite. You have a low, you have a high, then you have a lower low, then you have a lower high. Okay, so that is called a downtrend. Okay, so basically uptrend and downtrend is just the opposite. Okay, now the last type of market condition is known as a consolidation, where you have sort of like a resistance here and you have a support. Sorry, the drawing is terrible, but the support is something like this. So what happens is that price is actually bouncing between support and resistance, bounce up, bounce down. Okay, so these are the three types of market condition, and this is the first question that you need to ask yourself when you're taking a trade. Are you trading in alignment with the market condition? Okay, if you are in an uptrend, you don't want to be selling. Okay, conversely, if you are in a downtrend, you do not want to be buying. Okay, if in a consolidation, you can buy at the bottom and sell at the top, that's fine. Okay, but this is the first thing that you need to check. Okay, always make sure you check this. Okay, now by the way, our team has put together a 3-day trading guide for you. So just in case you have not gotten it, this is how the day trading guides look. Okay, it's very comprehensive, it's free. Okay, the link is in the description. You can see over here that it's very comprehensive. So if you are new, I recommend that you check this out. Okay, the link's in the description. Okay, we prepared it for you and we took a lot of time. Okay, so at the same time, please give us a thumbs up for this video, help us grow this channel, help us impact more traders, okay? Make sure you subscribe as well so that you get more of this kind of content that we put together for you on a daily basis, okay? So now that I've talked about our 3-day trade guide, I want to show you some examples of what do I mean by the market in the uptrend, downtrend, and consolidation, okay? Because I want to show you real examples. I don't just want to talk theory. Okay, so this is a euro dollar chart that I have for you over here. So you can see that... let me just draw it. So you can see that this is an uptrend. Okay, you might ask me, why is it an uptrend? Very simple. Let me just draw it. Okay, because you have a... Sorry. Just a moment. Okay, let me just draw it over here. Okay, so you have the... Just a moment, still not loading. Okay, sorry. I can't really draw it, but no problem. Here it is. So you can see over here that there's a high over here. There's a low. Okay, you have a higher high and then you have a higher low. Okay, so what is this? Okay, this is a uptrend as what I explained earlier. So this is the first thing you want to do. So in this case, we have a uptrend, we have a high, we have a low, we have a higher high, and then we have a higher low. Okay, so naturally in this kind of scenario, you want to be buying, you don't want to be selling. Okay, so let's take a look at the downtrend, which is just the opposite. Okay, the opposite is true. You have the low, you have the high, you have the lower low, then you have the lower high. Okay, pretty straightforward stuff. Okay, it's very straightforward, and that is why most traders, you know, they miss out this step. Okay, so please do not miss out this step. This is very important. Okay, this is the first question that you need to ask yourself. This is the first thing that you need to check on your checklist. Are you trading with the market condition? Okay, if the answer is no, then there is no point going through the other four checklists. Okay, you just want to make sure that this one, you check it. Okay, that you are trading in alignment with the market condition. Okay, and of course you have the last kind of market condition, which is the consolidation. So you can see over here that you have the the support and you have the resistance, and price is just bouncing between the two levels as what I've drawn in this green box. Okay, so this is the first thing. Now let's move on to the second thing. Okay, the second thing that you need to look at is the key support and resistance level. Okay, I go into that in our 3-day trading guide. Okay, we have a step-by-step process how to draw your support resistance. Okay, but for the purpose of this video, I just want to keep it simple. Okay, you need to ask yourself, where is price being supported and resisted currently? Okay, this could be a horizontal level, you know, it could be a trend line, it could be a moving average, it could be an equal distance channel. Okay, again, if you are new and you do not know what I'm talking about, we have a lot of videos. Okay, we have videos on trend lines, we have videos on support and resistance, we have videos on literally everything. Okay, moving average, equal distance channel, we cover everything. Okay, so if this is the first video that you're watching, make sure you check out other videos, make sure you subscribe. Okay, because we give you everything you need to know to become a profitable trader. Okay, you just need to put in the work and watch the video and start applying what we teach. Okay, so let me show you some examples just to help you understand better. Okay, so you can see that we are still looking at the euro dollar chart. Okay, so same thing, you have a breakout and then you have a pullback. Okay, so this is a very classic horizontal level, because if you look left, okay, you can see that this was the prior high, was broken and it came back as a support. Okay, in fact, in this case, you also have a moving average. This is a 20 period moving average. Okay, the 20 period moving average acted as a dynamic support. Okay, there was a confluence, meaning that the prior high, prior resistance turn support is in alignment with the moving average, and that makes it a very strong level. Okay, so you need to understand where are your key support and resistance level. You need to identify them before you take a trade. Okay, ideally, you want to enter your trade close to the support and resistance level as much as possible. So in this case, you want to enter a trade somewhere near here. Okay, so that's point, that's checklist number two. Okay, that's the second thing that you need to check when you're entering a trade. Are you near a support or resistance level? Okay, I have this one also, trend line. Okay, I have another example over here. It's a trend line. So how do you draw this? Okay, I won't go into the the details in this video, but basically you want to connect the two lows. You connect this low here and this low over here to project this low. Okay, I have a video on how to do this, so just check out our channel, type the word trend line and you should be able to find it. Okay, same thing, when you draw, you draw this trend line, you will know that this is a key support and resist. This is a key support level, sorry. Okay, so you'll be looking to buy over here. Okay, let me just move. Okay, and the last one, last example I have for you is a equal distance channel. Okay, so what, let me just clear this up first because it's a bit distracting. Okay, yeah, so this is an equal distance channel. Again, I have a video tutorial on how to draw this, but in this case, I just want to show you how you can find key support and resistance level. So if you just plot the you plot the top, the two swing highs and project down, you would tell that this is a good support level. This is a key support level. Okay, so you need to do this as well. Okay, you need to identify the key support and resistance level. Okay, So now let's move on to the third one, okay? Step one, right? Checklist one is you find out the market condition. Step two is you find the key support and resistance level, okay? Now step three has to do with your entry, okay? You need what is called a price action trigger. There is basically something that tell you when you should enter, right? Just because price is at a support or resistance doesn't mean you should enter. There must be a sign that tell you that you should be buying right now, okay? So basically a price action trigger is your signal to buy or sell, okay? So you need to ask yourself when you're entering a trade, when you're looking to take a trade, okay, this is the trend, this is the market condition, it's bullish, uptrend, and it's a key support level. But how will I buy off the level? Is it going to be an engulfing pattern? Do I buy when I see an engulfing pattern? Is it when there's a break of a trend line, or do I wait for a break of chart pattern, okay? These are just some triggers that you can consider. Again, in our 3-day training guide, we do teach you a couple of price action triggers. So make sure you check that out if you have not. Okay, I will not go into full details here. But what I'll do next is I want to show you some examples. Okay, so over here, we are looking back at the euro dollar example again. Okay, so early on, I show you that we draw the equidistance channel and we identify the key support level at the bottom of the equal distance channel. Okay, so if you are using a engulfing candle as a price action trigger, then you can see over here that I've marked out that will be your entry. Okay, when you see this engulfing pattern at your key support, then you enter the trade. Okay, now if you are using the trend line and you draw a trend line something like this, okay, and when the trend line breaks, okay, you can enter. Okay, in this case, your entry would be the same whether it's an engulfing pattern or a break of trend line. Okay, I just want to show you, how you can actually trigger your trade. Okay, but always make sure to have a form of price action trigger. Okay, now the last one is a chart pattern. Okay, so basically there are a few chart patterns. You have the head and shoulders. Okay, you have the inverted head and shoulders. You have the double bottom and the double top. Okay, in this case, I'll just show you the inverted head and shoulders. Okay, so basically when the chart pattern is validated, meaning that the neckline is broken, then you enter. Okay, if you're a bit confused, you do not know what I'm talking about, again, check out my other videos, because I have all these concepts being taught in other videos. I do not want to make this a 50 minutes video where I go on and on about things which I've already covered before. Okay, so this is how you do it. Okay, you enter on this candle over here when price breaks the neckline. Okay, so that's number three. You need to have a price action trigger. Okay, number four. Okay, number four is the fourth thing in your checklist is you need to know when to get out if you are wrong. Okay, okay. Here's the thing: you can never get it right 100% of the time. So you must always plan. What will happen if you are wrong, right? You need to know where you get out, okay? So how do you determine this, okay? You want to put your stop loss at a level where if price trades at, right, that means that your entire setup is wrong, okay? I see the mistake that a lot of new traders make is they set their stop loss based on their risk appetite. Okay, so what do I mean? Okay, let's say you are a new trader and for you, you realize that when your position is going against you 30 pips, you get upset and you cannot take it because 30 pips is too much for you. Okay, you shouldn't do that. Okay, you shouldn't risk your set your stop loss according to your risk appetite or according to how much you're losing. Okay, you should look at the charts, okay, and place your stop loss at a logical level. Okay, once you know the distance to your stop loss, then you want to size your trading position accordingly. Okay, such that let's say you are risking 30 pips, then you want to size your position size according to 30 pips. Okay, of course, if your stop loss is wider, it's 60 pips, then you want to size your trading position according to 60 pips instead. Okay, so you do not just want to enter, a random lot size and then not control your risk and, size your position correctly. Okay, so over here, I have an example for you. Okay, back to the same example. Let's say you entered somewhere here. Okay, you need to know when you are getting out. Okay, this is very, very crucial. Okay, you need to know in your checklist, whenever you take a trade, you must know for sure when you are getting out. Okay, if you do not know when you are getting out or when you are wrong, then please do not take the trade. Okay, this is very important. Please do not take the trade, because what will happen if you do not put a stop loss is that if price trades against you and you do not get out, okay, you're going to blow your account. Okay, and that's not what I want happen to you, okay, I've seen a lot of people blow their accounts and I do not want you to blow your accounts at all. Okay, so please always put a stop loss in, okay? Always know when you're getting out, okay? If you do not know when you are getting out, then do not enter the trade, okay? Then by default, you cannot check this box in your checklist and therefore you cannot take the trade, okay? So make sure you know when you're getting out. And of course, the last one, right? The last part of the checklist is you need to know when you get where you get out if you are right, okay? You've taken care of your worst case scenario, where you get out when you're wrong. Now let's talk about how, you know, when you get out, when you're right, right? How do you get out, okay? So the question to ask yourself is, are you capturing a swing in the market? What's your goal in taking the trade? Are you trying to catch a swing or are you trend riding? Okay, that's very important because if you are catching a swing, then you should put in a take profit level. But if you are trend riding, then technically you do not need to have a take profit level because you are just going to trail your stop as price moves in your direction. Okay, so just a couple of pointers for you to think about would be, are you going to set fixed take profit targets? Are you going to say, okay, I'm going to take profit at 30 pips, I'm going to lock some profit in at 60 pips and 90 pips and so on? Or are you going to target the nearest key support and resistance? Okay, or are you going to throw your stop loss? Okay, again, I cannot give you the answer for this because this is very personal and it's very dependent on the situation. But what I can do for you is I can give you some pointers for you to think about. Okay, so please do not just watch this video and, you know, forget about it. Do not think about it, right? Take some notes. Every time you enter a trade, make sure you ask yourself these questions, okay? Not just this point number five, right? Not just the checklist number five, but checklist 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, okay? So this is an example, okay? Back to just now the example. Let's say you entered here again. Okay, just a moment. Let me see if I can draw it for you. Okay, let's say you entered here, okay? So the question is, how are you going to manage your trade? Are you going to take your take profit at the upper range over here? Or are you going to trail your, you know, trail your stop loss? Maybe shave it here, and maybe shave it here and you get stopped out somewhere here. Okay. Again, I cannot give you the answer, but I can only point you in the direction, the right direction, right? By asking yourself some questions. Okay. You need to figure all this out before you enter the trade. Okay. Not after you enter the trade. Okay. A lot of traders, they enter the trade first, then they think about it later. Okay, please do not do that. If you want to be a consistently profitable trader, you want to be a professional trader, you need to plan your trade and then you trade your plan. Okay, please do not just click the button and then see how it goes. Okay, that doesn't work in trading because when you click the button, emotions come into play and you do stupid things because you did not plan for it. Okay, so please make sure you know how you are getting out as well. Okay, so that's the five checklist that I have for you, the five things. So just to end off this video, I'll do a recap. Okay, so the five things you need to do is that the first thing is ask yourself, what is the market condition? Okay, is it uptrend, downtrend, or is it consolidation? Okay, you want to trade with the market condition. The next thing that you need to consider is your key support and resistance level. Are you trading at a key support and resistance level? If you want to buy, make sure that the key support is near you. If you want to sell, make sure that the key resistance is near you. Okay, you want to look for a price action trigger to tell you when to enter the market off the key support and resistance level. Okay, and when you enter, you want to also know when you are going to get out if you're wrong and when to get out if you're right. How will you manage your trade if you are right? Okay, so please write down these five things, right? Five things you need when you enter a trade. Okay, personally, I always use these five things whenever I take a trade. Okay, if I'm not doing these five things, then I do not take a trade. It's that simple. Okay, so this will save you a lot of money if you just stick to it. Okay, so make sure you do it. Okay, as always, if you have any questions, just leave a comment down below. Okay, if this is helpful, also let us know so that we can create more content like this. Okay, if you have any specific issues that you want help on, it doesn't have to be related to this video. Just let us know, right? You can write in to us. We have a email, okay, support@financialmarketwizards.com. Just email us your questions. We'll create a video like this to serve you better, okay? If not, thank you for watching. We'll see you in the Telegram channel, okay?